Hey, what is up guys? It's Anup here, back with a new tutorial video. In this, today I'm going to discuss about night photography or low light and some tips to setting it up. So first thing first, intro. Obviously, we need to have a camera and a lens. If you talk about low light or a night photography, you know, you need a lower number aperture lens. So lower means the amount of light which goes inside the lens will be more. So like this 50mm which I use, it has 1.8 aperture lens. You know, lesser the aperture number or f number, you can say f stops, you know, more the light goes to your camera, so resulting a good quality photo. And lesser the aperture, you know, you will buy like 1.4 or 1.2, you have to pay extra for that, you know, but give you the best results. There will be in-depth tutorial about f-stops, you know, and the depth of field in another episode or a video, you know. So let's start with the sunset and backlit subjects. So here is an example of a tree with no leaves and a bottle is hanging on the branches. So the best shot you can take is like this. I'm using the shutter around 1/2500. The full stop, or you can say aperture, of f1.8. The ISO over here is 2000. So the white balance is I use mostly is Kelvin temperature. The natural settings for an human eye, I will suggest 5000 to 5500 Kelvin. Correct me if I'm wrong. You can click this picture in many ways. So by decreasing the shutter speed and increasing the f-stop, or decreasing the shutter and the f-stop, another side increasing the ISO, so you can obtain this kind of picture, but might show up some little grains, but this picture is kind of okay. Now this is the same picture with different settings, look like this. So same setting, but increase in f-stops from 1.8 to 7.1. By setting it up, you can obtain this kind of picture. Moving on, so if you see this picture, in this we have enough artificial lights. The setting which I use is the shutter of 1/400, focal stop that is f1.8, and ISO is 2500. The reason why I'm saying the full stop instead of focal stop, because they are same. If you're in a crowded place like this, you can find lots of movement, so capturing less movement blur and still pictures. So minimum shutter can be used is 1/400. Below that, the subject starts to move, causing motions. Second, the fireworks, you know, always remember that the exposure time should be more to obtain this kind of picture you need for a firework. Set your shutter speed or to minimum 1/3 to maximum of 10 to 15 seconds. You know, for 1/3 it's for a small firework, as I say, and for 10 to 15, it's a huge, like massive firework is going on, you know, on the skies. For that you can set it up to 10 seconds or maybe 15 seconds, not more than that. That means your aperture blades, you know, will be open for that 10 seconds of period, you know, resulting capturing more content and spread out shot. Aperture should be f11, because far from your camera, and the ISO, set it to minimum, that is 100. As a reference from my another picture, you know, as you can see here, it's a sprinkle fireworks, you know, I used 1/4 of shutter speed in this, so rest of the settings are same. So the third one, the sunset. Sunsets are my, you know, second lovable thing this world. Well, for example, in this picture, shutter speed I use of 1/160, f-stop is f6.3, ISO is 100. Next, fourth one, night traffic, you know, light trails. I'm a huge fan of night trails. So here is one picture with setting exposure time, that is shutter speed of 15 seconds, and ISO I used 100, and the f-stop should be 20. So for Y20, because there will be any lights which are still, you are taking any pictures in street or highway, you know, there will be a street lamps, for that getting a flare from that light, you can set it up to 20. So don't forget to place it in a still position, or for example, you can use your tripod. Here is the next picture with same settings. Fifth one is moon photography. First, here's a picture of full moon, you know, a little bit cloudy, but the shutter speed I have used in this one, 1/500 seconds. ISO I used, as I said, 100, f-stop of 6.3. Obviously you need a zoom lens or a digital zoom for this one to take this kind of picture, whether you are owning a normal digital camera or a zoom lens. Next one from the reference, last one, you know, this is the semicircle moon. I took this picture, you know, 1 week after this one. So this one probably the half moon, I can say that. So for this, the shutter speed I have used 1/250 seconds, f-stop of 7.1 and ISO of 100. So the sixth one is like dusky sky, you know, like this, shutter speed of 1/3200 seconds, f-stop of 7.1, ISO 2000. Reference to this, the next picture, you know, shutter speed of 1/800 seconds, f-stop of 5.6 and the ISO is 800. Last but not the least, the star photography, the seventh one. Unfortunately, I have no picture of my own. So as I live in the south part of India, due to the city pollution, stars are barely visible over here. So, but as a reference, my friend took, who used to stay in north side of India. So for this, I recommend a tripod with a good grip and setting up your camera with a setting like shutter speed of 20 to 30 seconds. F-stop of 2.8 to 5, you know, between that, according to your environment which you are in, set it up. ISO according to your surroundings, if you have a dark environment or artificial lights around you, so you can set the ISO up to 800, and if the stars are barely visible, you can use the ISO 3200. So this is for this episode, guys. Hope I helped you understanding a little bit of, you know, nightscape photography, or you can say night photography. You can find me on Instagram for more photography and cinematic. Thank you for watching, guys. I will see you in the next vlog.